What is culture? Well, we will let Andre walk us through the dimensions of culture and its relationship to context.
Context is everything. Believe it or not, there was a time when people would refer to Brazil nuts by another name. They would refer to them as the N-word toes. So you get the N-word, right? Okay, cool. I find that interesting because in my family system, we never called them the N-word toes. We called them Brazil nuts. And after doing my research, I realized that they're more of a seed than they are a nut. But for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, Brazil nuts usually come around the holiday times, particularly in Western countries, right? So they're this 2-inch nut or inch and a half nut that is shaped like a wedge of an orange, an orange wedge, and is mahogany on the outside, very dark on the outside. And so there was a time when people would refer to that nut with the other way of speaking. And did they create, the people who were using those words, did they create that word or the use of the word? I would say that they did not. I will say that they were in a time and an environment that the world around them was using that term, and so they felt that it was the right term to use. However, if people wanted to use that term to describe those nuts today, how would we respond to them? What would we say to them about using the N-word as a part of their everyday vernacular? We would say that that is not the right thing to do, that politically correct, you shouldn't say those things, or you know, is there another way to describe those without using that word? We would be embarrassed. And why is that? Because the context has changed. So context is everything. Context is everything. So what we know about human behavior is that people are always striving, and they're striving for three things. They're looking for safety, significance, and belonging. And when you get a group of people, that group is also looking for safety, significance, and belonging. But they have to contend with something that is oftentimes unchangeable, or in some ways they look to manage this thing called context. And context is the geographic region, the kind of political or educational environment that we've grown up in, and it is also the time frame in which we've grown up. And so when we recognize that human beings are always dealing with this context, and what do we know about context? Time is always changing. Geographic regions adjust, and people move from different places, and that governments move at the whims of the people. So context is constantly changing. And so if people are trying to adapt their behaviors to this context, and context is constantly changing, what must people also do with their behaviors? Their behaviors must move with the context. And so when we talk about this idea of context being everything, what we recognize is that cultural shifts are actually responses to a variation in the context. And so as context changes, so must human behavior. However, the deep need for safety, significance, and belonging is still present in human interactions. So when we think about our organizations, when we think about ourselves, we must ask ourselves, are there ways in which we have been taught to or raised or reared to see the world, to form a paradigm, a worldview that may no longer be necessary given the change in the context? And so we'll spend more time talking about why context is so important and how cultures develop out of context.
Wow. Andre did a great job explaining how culture and context are connected. As context changes, so does culture. Context demands a response, and culture is the response.